Hello. God bless you. I'd like to speak to us this evening on this message which has been bothering me, which has been coming all along. Occasionally, the Spirit of God ministers to me concerning this message, concerning misconception, misunderstanding among the Christendom. And he led me to speak to more especially all the leaders of the gospel around the world. Who are the leaders of the gospel around the world? The apostles, the evangelists, the prophets, the teachers, the pastors. According to Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11, as he gave unto the church, most of the people who are called apostles, prophets, teachers, bishops, evangelists, or whatsoever around the world today confuse the doctrines of the Bible, because the Spirit made me to know expressly that most of them don't reach and they don't study the Bible, and they do not seek counsel from God before they deliver their messages to the people. Now I am led to speak on this message, which is correcting errors among the Christendom and enforcing general divine wisdom of the Word of God. Correcting errors among the Christendom and enforcing general divine wisdom of the world. I hereby collect my text from the book of Revelations, Revelation from chapter 22, verse 18. For I testify to everyone who hears the words of the prophecy of this book. If anyone adds to these things, God will add to him the plagues that are written in this book. Verse 19, and if anyone takes away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God shall take away this his part from the book of life, from the holy city, and from the things which are written in this book. I'd like to tell us that we have a lot of people today who preach so many messages, are clear with the assorted doctrines. Some are preaching from their own hearts. Some are preaching from self. Some preach from the Bible, but not where directed. Some try to claim that they preach holiness so that people will call them the best preachers all over the world. Some try to preach messages accrued to heaven so that people will call them heavenly conscious preachers. I like to tell us that some people around the world today who preaches holiness to people are not preaching complete messages to people. How can you be preaching holiness to people without bringing in all the doctrines of the Bible from Genesis to Revelation and making it clear to them there are scriptures that Jesus Christ came, he did not remove them, but he amended them. He told us that he did not come to abolish the law, but that the law might be fulfilled. How can you be running church for many years now, telling people to be holy, but you don't allow them to prophesy? You deduct, you remove the gifts of the Holy Spirit only to teach them the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Yes, we should understand that there are perishable gifts and there are imperishable gifts. But for the fact we are in this world, we should genuinely and godly possess both the perishable gifts and the imperishable gifts. For example, in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 through 23 and verse 24, you have the fruits of the Holy Spirit listed here. We should preach and teach the people the fruits of the Holy Spirit: joy, love, meekness, faithfulness, patience, long-suffering, and all that. When you come to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, from verse 7 through 9, is teaching concerning the gift of the Holy Spirit. You have 9 major gifts of the Holy Spirit there. But I find out that many people, or some preachers who claim to be holiness preachers among the Christendom today, don't believe in prophecy. They don't believe in discerning of the Spirit. They don't believe in miracles. They don't allow their members to preach miracles and prophesy. But the Bible teaches us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 19, that we should not quench the Spirit. In verse 20, it says we should not despise prophecies. What it means is that every child of God should be taught to prophesy the word of God, to encourage himself or herself, and to encourage others while he preached the Bible, the word of God, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, prophecy. We should not dispute the members of the church from exercising the gift of the Holy Spirit. While we teach them fruits of the Holy Spirit to live a pure-hearted life, we should also teach them to live a prophetic life. We should also teach them to live a successful life. We should also teach them on how to bind demons. Because Jesus Christ, when he was here, he bind demons. We should not dispute or prevent the congregation from binding demons. It is only when it is done ungodly or when it is done carnally that we should be warning them, but we should allow the people who we are pastoring in the church and the people that are following us as leaders of the gospel around the world to understand the whole truth of the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. The Bible teaches that whoever deduct the word of God, the place of the Bible will be added to him or her. In Revelation chapter 22, verse 19, if anyone turns away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God shall like take away his part from the book of life. You are preaching holiness to people, but you don't preach prophecy to people. You don't preach discerning spirit to people. You don't allow people to speak in tongues in your church. I want to let you know that you must take correction from today. You must take correction from today and begin to teach the congregation on the gift of the Holy Spirit, how to exercise the gift of the Holy Spirit. You are not the one that wrote the Bible. Bible were written by the inspiration of God through men that he chose. According to the Bible, the word of God is 2 Timothy chapter 3 from verse 15 through 16. You have no power, you have no right, you are not permitted to deduct the word of God and claim that you are teaching people holiness. Holiness without the gift, enforcement, combined inclination of the gift of the Holy Spirit, exercising of spiritual warfare, praying in tongues, wrought miracles, exercising power over demons, is not complete. Begin to correct these errors in your church. As a pastor, as an apostle, as a general overseer, as a general superintendent, as a branch pastor, as an assistant pastor, as a teacher of the gospel, as an evangelist, and they shall be well with you. When our Lord Jesus Christ was here, he bind demons. He told us in Matthew 16:19 that he has given us the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever we bind on earth shall be bind in heaven. In Mark chapter 5, if you read all through from verse 1 through, you will see a man that was bound and kept in bondage by demons. It was Jesus that delivered him. You don't believe in deliverance and you are preaching holiness to people. I want to let you know that you don't understand the meaning of holiness. You should take correction today. Holiness means the complete exercising and knowledge, wisdom, and practical exercise of the truth of the Word of God from Genesis to Revelation. And God bless you. This message, which is titled Correcting Errors Among the Christendom and Enforcing General Wisdom Through the Word of God, we continue someday. And God bless you. In Jesus Christ's name.